Regarding rising sea levels in the biblical worldview, Noah's flood created ideal conditions for an ice age, beginning right after the flood, lasting for several hundred years. There's plenty of evidence for an ice age, including the erosion of landscapes, scraping of bedrock, the leftover rocks and boulders from retreating ice sheets, leftover ice caps, and much more.
Cappuccino?
Not that kind of ice cap. Naturalists suggest there have been many ice ages over millions of years, though the evidence really just points to one.
As you can imagine, since Noah's flood, there have been massive changes in sea level, and there's evidence for this that scientists can see today, like old shorelines, marine fossils, and small fossil coral reefs on land. This graph includes the secular timeline, so that needs some adjusting. But it shows the rise in sea level since the height of the Ice Age, when the glaciers were at their largest. It shows that at that time, sea level was about 120 meters, or 390 feet, lower than now.
Right, and in the creation model, the sea level values indicated here would also change for a variety of reasons. Yeah. One of those is there were no ice sheets immediately after the flood.
Okay.
The Greenland and Antarctic ice sheets developed during a single post-flood ice age, rapidly at first and then continuing to build slowly until reaching a steady state.
Because of that, and recalibrating uniformitarian assumptions on the size of the ice sheets, recent studies suggest that sea level was about 68 meters or 220 feet higher at the end of the flood than it is now.
Yeah.
As ice sheets grew over a few hundred years, sea level dropped dramatically to about 55 meters or 180 feet below today's level, and then rose as the ice age melted.
Right, and satellite measurements indicate sea levels are currently rising at about 3.3 millimeters per year or about 1 foot per hundred years, assuming the data is accurate. Calibration of satellites is quite complex, right, with many factors affecting it. Keep in mind, global sea level can't be measured locally because continents also go up and down. For example, much of northern Europe is rising, rebounding after being pushed down during the Ice Age. Other factors include volcanic and tectonic activity.
But what if all the ice in the Arctic Sea and all the icebergs melted? It wouldn't raise the sea level.
Really?
Remember learning about Archimedes in school?
Who?
The bathtub guy, remember?
Oh, yeah, Eureka.
You can see the Archimedes principle at home when you put an ice cube in a glass of water.
Okay.
As the ice cube melts, its density increases while its volume decreases.
Oh.
So it takes up only the space displaced by the ice. So the water level doesn't change.
Oh, unless you drink some of it, right?
So back to Arctic ice. If the Arctic becomes ice-free, if all the ice sea ice melts, there'll be no change in sea level. The melting of ice on land would cause sea level to rise.
Right.
A study of grounded ice volumes in Greenland and Antarctica showed a loss of ice from 2003 to 2019, resulting in a 14 millimeter rise in sea level over 16 years. If all of Antarctica's grounded ice were to melt, sea level would rise about 57 meters or 190 feet.
Right, and now that would be a problem for anyone living close to the ocean near sea level.
Yeah.
But don't panic. At current melting rates, it'll take 82,000 years to get that far. No need to call the moving van just yet.